Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Call of Duty Championship presented by Xbox. Gandhi, joined by my comrade here.
I am one half of the VP brothers. Unfortunately, my brother didn't make it, Momo, but Rel is my name. If you guys want to follow me, our Twitters are at the bottom, and we are just getting straight into this.
Oh, he did it.
I had to do it. Do you know what? I haven't done it the whole time, but I felt I should just say, it's right here.
Yeah.
Just, you know,
Ball of Three, man. If you see it and I talk it and then I talk it again, you'll follow.
There we go. Subliminal messaging. Oh, I figured while it's Optic, you know, I might as well get it out there.
I've always loved Green Wall.
Oh, yeah, man. Green Wall, definitely. But anyway, Search and Destroy Warhawk is the next map and game mode, and of course it is NSP, the South Korean team, going up against Optic, 1-0 currently to Optic Gaming.
Yep, and you know, this is one I want to see. I want to see what Clayster's going to bring out on Warhawk. I mean, we've seen every kind of spectrum from him. We've seen him run subs, we've seen him run ARs, and personally I want to see him snipe. I miss the Clayster who used to just be so confident as a sniper, right? And at the LAN, you know, I think he kind of got away with it from just a little bit, and just a couple series, just because he wanted to get used to everything else, but I mean, it's go time here. We are jumping straight into the action and already hanging out. And he does have it.
Yeah. There we go. He puts it on now. And they are on the attack, making a switch.
Oh, no!
Hey, oh, and he just turned away at the wrong moment there. He could have possibly made that kill. And he's got the variable scope. Just popping it out. The grenade is going to provide some cover, though, to allow that push onto A by nade shot.
Yeah, and NSP should know right now that, well, I don't see anyone at B. I'm pretty sure they're going to be going A. Clayster's just, you know, staring down the barrel of a 45, just hanging out.
Well, he's got the cutoff, hasn't he? So there's just no way that NSB can advance without him at least seeing them and making the call to his teammates.
I mean, he's forcing their hands here. He has one guy crossing, misses that shot just by a little bit. Guy's going to challenge it. Clayster, down he goes.
Okay, let's see what's going to happen with Embos, because
he's rocking a sniper too. Look at Embos.
He's also got the sniper.
Let me find out Money B can snipe.
Oh, and he just put it away at the wrong moment, so it's just Scump and Nade Shot all up against Benjamin Nuri. He's going for the clutch. He needs to get the defuse as well.
Oh,
takes down Nade
Mother
Shot.
Teresa.
One versus one. Scump versus Benjamin Nuri. Can he pull this off? Can he pick up three of these kills and get the defuse?
Nah.
There's not going to be enough time left on the clock, so Scump plays it smart. He doesn't go for the challenge, but now he is going to be able to.
That's veteran play right there.
Exactly, you know, and he's showing his experience. He just kept his distance. Sure, Scump may have been confident that he could outgun him in a one versus one situation, but why take that risk?
Yeah, there's no need. I mean, it takes 7.5 seconds to defuse, hang out till 8, and then just kind of poke around and see if he's on that bomb.
Yeah, I mean, let's talk about how Optic Gaming actually qualified for this in the US regional. So they beat Denial West, but then they fell down against Envious 3-1 following the 3-0 victory. So then it came down to the Optic Gaming versus Curse New York, and that was I wouldn't say the surprise, because you know
that was a doozy.
It was always going to be a close game, but Optic Gaming took it 3-2, and that allowed them to qualify.
They absolutely slapped them in that search in game 5 as well, which, you know, going into it, search was a little bit shaky for Optic. I mean, everyone knew kind of before US Finals, it was like round 11s never go in favor of Optic. And then they started winning the round 11s. But, I mean, that game 5 was like a 6-1. Curse New York just couldn't answer it.
Yeah, of course. And Curse New York, being Revan, Machilla, Blindfire, and Burnsoff, just got completely shut down by Optic. And that's a big snipe there, as Benjanuri did go for the push on the bomb.
Was that Bose?
I'm going to check who is using the sniper.
Bose.
It's Scumpy.
Oh, my God. They're running two snipes. Two snipper snaps.
Yeah.
It's like the movie Shooter.
Art shot, though.
Oh.
Sneak around the back.
Look at this.
Here we go. Is it going to get he does take a knife to the chest. Now, Deloshi all on his own up against Embos and Scump. Does get the plant, though.
Oh. Imagine he hits that quick scope, though, right?
That would have been brilliant.
That would have been.
I would have loved it.
I would have started quitting. I would have turned off the box and said, okay, rest in peace.
Again, though, he just chose the wrong moment to actually switch that gun. Quite unfortunate. And then he's just going to take a Semtex to the butt. But that's going to be 2-0 now to Optic Gaming in this Search and Destroy.
Going into round 3 here, I mean, they're back on offense. They looked very strong in the opening break. I wonder if they're going to continue to go A. I think A is kind of their comfort. I mean, they put Clayster on that fence, and he does so well with those snipes. Normally, 9 times out of 10, he does it. And we got a sniper from Nate Shot, barely misses that guy.
Yeah, that's quite unfortunate, really. I mean, one thing I would say, generally on Search and Destroy in this map, you usually see the B bomb push. But, you know, Optic Gaming deciding or favoring the A bomb site so far. Two do go down, though, leaving Clayster and Embos all alone against Turbo and Benjanuri.
Yeah, the A bomb push has kind of turned into like a North American thing. I mean, all these teams kind of realize, like, do we really want to go through trophies and smokes and stuns on B, or do we want to just force a gunfight in American? That's which is the building.
Because I mean,
I know you probably don't call it American. You call it probably.
Oh no, it's American at our end of the pond as well. Yeah,
we but win.
This is the thing. I mean, it's in the European scene. It's generally the B bomb site that people are most comfortable going to. A bomb site's kind of the random one, the surprise bomb site. So,
oh, interesting.
Yeah, but that is going to be the end of the third round here, and once again that goes to Optic Gaming. So really showing the dominance here on Search and Destroy.
He Batmaned him. You see that? He jumped out of the window.
He
so
just
like
started
nothing.
Flying around the map and just, picking up kills.
Whatever.
I mean, every single player in this game picking up kills so far, apart from Deloshi. So, you know, I wanna see what he can do. I wanna see if he can turn this around with that sniper.
I want you to give me your odds of him ripping someone's face off right off the break.
I'm gonna say 1-3.
1-3. Oh, that's a lean. Okay, well,
maybe it was accidental. I don't know.
If it wasn't, if this was a close series, I mean, obviously he's freaking out.
Oh,
stuns himself. He's like, you know what? I've been such a bad boy. I just want to take myself out.
Yeah, he was, you know, he knew what he did.
God knows what's right, you know? That's what it is. The COD gods know what's right.
So, unfortunately, the stun is going to mean it is his end. Benjinari now does have the bomb, and that is who we're spectating. All the remaining players, only
where
three kills.
Where did that come from?
Yeah, just a random grenade just floating into postage there. So, Artshot also goes down. Turbo, what is going on? One versus two. Clayster and Nadeshot, he needs to get both of these kills.
He is going to push in the post office, or he's going to wrap around gate? I would like to see him push through gate. But he is going to have a guy pushing there, and oh, just wasn't able to finish it. Just like that, nade shot closes it out.
Yep, and there we go. So it's going to be 4-0 now. And, you know, we are seeing the South Korean team, NSP, making some moves there. I think it was 2-2 at one point. We had one person in loading bay and one sweeping around the back in post office. But, hey, 4-0 now. The scoreline just truly showing who is the greater team on Search and Destroy.
So who are you starting off with? Are you staying on board with NSP?
Well, I mean, what I like to do, I always like to see the attack inside, so, you know, it gives us an even distribution of coverage.
There's one.
And there's the sniper. But it also allows us to see the more aggressive gameplay for the attack.
They forgot the bomb.
They got a bit too excited, I think.
Clayster was like, hey, guys, you forgot your briefcase.
Yeah, we should probably pick this up and go for a plan. But 4-2 now, things just looking better and better as this best of five series progresses. Remember, there are only three teams in this pool, Epsilon, Optic, and NSP.
Clayster now looks like he's going to push through top drug, and doesn't matter, it's 5-0. Are they going to make it the perfect search game? Is it going to be 6-0? I mean, I haven't seen much out of NSP to kind of be like, NSP can take a round. Like, I mean, I just haven't seen it. I've seen miracles before, but
yeah,
I'm not seeing it.
I mean, just simply from looking at the, you know, the kill death ratio, which I feel is more significant on Search and Destroy sometime, we can see everyone is negative by the same 3-5. Deloshi, though, really, really struggling here. And I want to watch him because, you know, for his sake, I'm almost hoping he gets a kill here.
When, you know, if you're Deloshi, if you're a player and, you know, you're 0-5, or if you're really 0-3 and you've been running the sniper every single time, you got to stop and just be like, oh, my God!
He's done it! He's done it! Deloshi with a quick scope.
Anyways, minus that, whatever you want to call it, if you're 0-3 and you find yourself down three rounds, you got to just put it away and pull out an AR. You can't rely on the snip snap.
Yeah, I mean, he's been determined to get a kill with that, I think.
Oh, he was.
He's been running it the whole time. He's like, I am going to snipe an Optic member.
Yeah, exactly. He's like, oh, man, I know I'm going to snipe Nadeshot. I totally going to get it.
I love it. I kind of just want a Twitter avatar now that says, I support Deloshi. That's what I want from this.
And Scump's going to get it, and just like that, Optic Gaming making quick work as Nadeshot's like, you know what, Scump, man, I kind of wanted to defuse it.
Oh, Nadeshot. Naughty, naughty. And he does take down Scump, but the bomb is defused, which is going to mean a 6-0 victory on the Search and Destroy, a pure show of class from Optic Gaming, and it's just brilliant to actually watch them play like that.
Yeah, they're looking really good versus NSP. I mean, obviously their big matchup is going to be Epsilon, but based on already, I mean, they're shooting good. Mm-hmm. They're confident. We can't see them. They're like way over yonder, but I got to think they're all smiles over there.
Oh, yeah, and I mean, they've got to be going into this blitz confident now following a massive victory on the Domination, a 6-0 victory on the Search and Destroy. You can only expect a big victory on Blitz, too.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive. I think if you're NSP, you're kind of like, well,
I mean,
showed up to the station.
I've got to say, with the NSP guys, what I love about it is they're still taking this seriously.
Yeah.
You know, even though the odds are against them there, they know how strong Optic are. They're giving this the role.
Yeah. Well, we are going to go to a quick commercial break. When we come back, Freight Blitz, stay tuned.